Good morning to you and yours during this holiday season as we stand outside US Bank Stadium once again for another Vikings home game. Vikings, of course, taking on the Jacksonville Jaguars this week, looking to get back to 500. And that's my question to you is, can they get back to 500? It'd be the first time in a while that they've gotten themselves in the same the win column as the loss column. It has been a tough year for the Vikings, but they seem to have been piecing things together ever since the bye week. And after another win over Carolina in comeback fashion, dramatic here last week, they're hoping for a little bit better of a cushion in this one against a Jaguars team that has lost 10 straight games. But we all know that the Vikings cannot afford to overlook any opponents here in the NFL, especially one that has been pretty feisty at times. The Jaguars are decimated by injuries this season, let's face it. They were 0-0. They were 0-0. That's 500. That's what I was saying back to. But the Jaguars have been really, really hampered by injuries this season. It has shown, but they have shown a lot of spirit in fighting some teams like the Packers, like the Browns. They've had some tough games and have shown some fight in them. And so it's Vikings just have not been good enough to just like blow by anybody other than the Lions this season. They played a lot of close games, 3 1-point games the Vikings have been in, only won one of them. So here's hoping that the Vikings can set an early tone in this one and really kind of, get a win here today at home as they should. Again, the third straight home game that they've had. Who cares? I care, because the Vikings are actually still in the playoff picture here. It's an outside chance. I think it's like a 27% chance right now, statistically speaking, that they make the postseason. But, you win games down the stretch here and you can maybe get into a good spot. You win four of your last five, I should say, and all of a sudden you're 9-7 and definitely in a playoff conversation. You're going to need some help. The Arizona Cardinals are probably the team most in reach to catch, to get part of that 7-team playoff field in the NFC. Cardinals are playing the Rams today and are one game currently ahead of the Vikings. So, hey, Vikings win today, Rams beat the Cardinals, all of a sudden you're tied with the Arizona. You still have tough games left on the schedule, I realize that. You've still got to play the New Orleans Saints. You've still got to play the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and there's some daunting tasks that lie ahead, but the Vikings are playing really good football, and as long as they continue to get a healthy dose of Dalvin Cook, and thank goodness he is back from last week's injury. Adam Thielen is back in the lineup today. We're happy to report off that COVID reserve list. Kirk Cousins has plenty of weapons, including Justin Jefferson, who is 82 yards away from hitting the 1,000-yard plateau on the season, which is super exciting. Irv Smith is out at tight end today, and DJ Wonnum is out at defensive end for the Vikings. So those are a couple key injuries. Alexander Mattison at backup running back is out as well for today's game. But the Jaguars are going with Mike Glennon at quarterback, who actually had a decent game last week, I guess. James Robinson at running back has been a fantastic source of dynamic offense for them this season. And so he's obviously one to keep your eye on as well. I'm always a fan too. BB with the touchdown catch against Carolina. We're hoping for more of the same today. But with Thielen back in the offense, I think you're going to see, obviously, Olabisi Johnson and Chad Beebe, taking a step back in their production levels. But it's nice to have them in the pocket as well, especially with Irv Smith out today. I hope that line is a good game. There you go. Skull Vikings, right? I mean, that's the bottom line. We'll be back with another Facebook Live here at halftime. And hopefully have some good things to have at you. And then, of course, post-game. And then tonight after Sunday Night Football, of course, Dave Schwartz and myself with the Vikings Extra, bringing you all the latest from what hopefully is a Vikings victory and hopefully gets them back to 500. Kirk Cousins is the NFC Offensive Player of the Week coming into this game. He's been riding a good wave of momentum. Dalvin Cook is the reigning Offensive Player of the Month in the NFC, so the Vikings are doing some really good things offensively, and goodness knows defensively they're doing really well too. They only gave up one touchdown last week against Carolina. Carolina, of course, had two defensive touchdowns. But the defense has been playing really well, and Eric Kendricks has been just a sight to behold this season. So we'll watch for him today as well. I have faith in them too, and let's leave it on that note. Skull Vikings, purple pride, as Red McCombs used to say, and we'll